Yeah.
Because it's not, you know what?
It's not why out. The, yeah.
Thank you.
Welcome to Fort Hunt Hamilton High School's commencement exercises of the 82nd academic year. I am Rosaria Mancini, Assistant Principal of Pupil Personnel Services. I request that you please stand for the presentation of the colors by our junior ROTC color guard and to continue to remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance, which will be led by the Senior Council Vice President, Andrew Scobo.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Thank you to our junior ROTC, led by Sergeant Frank E. Lambert. And once again, welcome and congratulations to the class of 2023. Congratulations on a job well done. To the graduates. To the graduates, remain focused, engaged, and always hold gratitude in your heart for your abilities, your family, your friendships, and your education. And now is with gratitude and honor that I present our distinguished staff who have made your experience at Fort Hamilton worthwhile. Our assistant principal of social studies, Gregory Abood. Assistant principal of science, John Christakos. Assistant principal of instructional support services, Christine Ciccaroni. Assistant principal of security, Stephen Hulkey. Assistant principal of EENL and World Languages, Jill Kitchen. Assistant principal of English, Denise Criticos. Assistant principal of Health, Physical Education, and JROTC, Kristen Lamacchia. Assistant principal of Mathematics, Mary Minucci. Assistant principal of Instructional Support Services, Nadine Mitchell. And now our college advisors, Fran Ferrara and Danielle Albanese. Welcome. It is my pleasure to introduce our esteemed instructional leader and principal, Kay Houlihan.
Thank you, Mrs. Vancini. Good morning, board graduates, families, and friends of graduates, and of course, our beloved board staff. Welcome to the 82nd academic year in Fort Hamilton High School's history, and we're proud of that history. Today, we recognize the accomplishments of the class of 2023, each individual, as well as the collective whole. Cohort 2023. Just over 1,000 students, you are an impressive group for many reasons, namely the number of transitions during the last 4 years of high school. You persisted through remote and hybrid learning, and then returned to maximize your last 2 years of in-person learning and were gained performing in the arts, athletics, and a range of other activities at Fort Hamilton. Congratulations for making it to the finish line and fulfilling all high school requirements. Many of you exceeded those requirements by contributing to the school community, excelling in advanced courses, and participating in our many special programs and extracurriculars. Everyone earns a diploma on completion of the requirements, but 4 years at Fort Hamilton is measured by the investment you made in yourself during your high school career. Take stock of your investment and credit yourself and the people around you who work to support your preparation for life after Fort. Special thanks to parents for their support of our school and graduates, particularly our Parent Teacher Association, and our excellent Fort staff that is committed to students and our school as they extend themselves every day to provide for students in and out of the classroom. I want to thank our leadership team, most of them on stage today, for putting students first and working to ensure they had every opportunity to succeed over the last 4 years. A round of applause for all the supports to the graduates today. Thank you. Class of 2023, thank you for making us proud. Remember that you can still be part of the Fort community through active membership in the Fort Alumni Association. And as you know, alumni return to visit, volunteer, teach, see performances, and cheer at sporting events. You will always be a member of the Fort family. You've worked hard, you've tried new things, You've given back to school and community. You've asked questions and been thoughtful about learning. And you've created long-lasting friendships, both with each other and the rest of our community, that will see you through to the next steps. I can also say that you have been positive and productive. My wish is that you continue to be positive and productive in all you do, in learning and work, family and relationships, and making contributions to support your community as you've supported Fort Hamilton. We are proud of you and the opportunities you've created for your future, and we'll always have high expectations for the class of 2023. Thank you for demonstrating leadership and spirit throughout the year. We wish you all the best. Jeff Brizard, Fort Hamilton's current Assistant Principal of Programming and Technology, is retiring in September. He is a man of few words. You can clap for Jeff. He is a man of few words, but significant action at Fort Hamilton for the last 31 years. Mr. Brizard became a teacher of social studies in 1992 and was briefly supervised by AP Gregory Abood. But he soon added other roles to his contributions at Fort. He helped organize school events, led a Council for Unity class, advised the Black Heritage Club, and became a dean in the cafeteria in 1993. From the beginning of his Fort career, Mr. Brizard implemented computerized procedures, particularly for organizing the Regents and lunch program. He started assisting in the program office in 2003 as the assistant program chair and testing coordinator, and he became the AP of Programming and Technology in 2004. Since that time, Mr. Brizard has led the heavy task of programming our large, comprehensive high school with multiple programs and priorities to balance with our 5,000 plus students over the years. He built a staff of computer tech specialists to support the expanding needs of our school technology and created a tech squad of students to learn and assist. We are grateful and proud that he coordinated the effort to ensure every classroom and office at Ford were fully equipped with the latest technology. Most recently, he was able to see through our push to increase the bandwidth, which is now triple the capacity from September of 2022. I am fortunate to have worked with Mr. Brizard for the last 11 years, where his humor and expertise go hand in hand. Both will be missed, but he will always be a dear member of the Fort family, and he'll continue to support our school with spirit and friendship. And now it's time for Mr. Brizard to throw out the opening and closing pitch.
Thank you. Congratulations. I'm joking. Bonjour. C'est l'honneur d'être ici avec vous aujourd'hui. Bonjour. C'est honneur de vous voir là avec nous aujourd'hui. See if you Google that. That was French and Creole, part of my heritage. In English, it means good morning. It is an honor to be here with you all today. Don't worry, Brizard's a man of few words, so it will not be a long speech. As I look around Fort Hamilton, it is a great representation of our multicultural nation, and I'm sure you are as proud of your heritage as I am of mine. I was born in Haiti under the rule of Papa Doc Duvalier, one of the most brutal despots in the history of the Western Hemisphere. Duvalier and his secret police, the Tonton Bakou, murdered and imprisoned tens and thousands of Haitians to retain his grip of power. I have vivid memories from my childhood of having to hide underneath the bed when the Tonton Bakou rolled around in the streets. The few who did speak out were punished, but I'm proud to come from a family who felt compelled to speak the truth in the face of such consequences. One of Duvalier's political prisoners was my grandfather, a classic music conductor who used his position in front of the captive audience to speak out against injustice. In 1970, fearful that they might soon be arrested, my parents, both educators, fled Haiti, leaving me and my siblings with my maternal grandmother. They found work in New York City, struggled to obtain permanent residency, but finally were able to move the rest of our family to the U.S. in 1976, 6 years after they left their home. My parents instilled the importance of education, hard work, and standing up for what you believe in. I was a very shy ELL student during my first few years in America, since I spoke little English. Not too enough. As I realized how beautiful Creole and French are, especially at the Tifino, Google that one also. My confidence grew. Confucius spoke, choose a job you love and you will never work a day in your life. And Nelson Mandela once said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. While you may have heard these words before, combined, they will continue to take on new meanings as you grow older. These two quotes together will help tell the story of the little boy from Guadeloupe, du Nord in Haiti, who turned into the man standing in front of you today. As a little boy, I dreamed of flying F-16 jets, and later I dreamed of becoming an engineer to design and build rockets. During my first year of college, I quickly realized that engineering wasn't for me. So I switched to math and economics with the goal of going to actual science. Immediately after graduation, I was hired by a large bank. So happy. Soon after, I realized the main reason I was hired was to fill a quota for a merger. I left the company as I'm nobody's token. My brother, an assistant principal at the time, suggested that I become a substitute teacher while I could start in my next steps. And I fell in love with teaching. There are some of you who already know what you are going to do after graduation. Some of you have concrete plans for your future, while others may be unsure and still searching. Regardless, I want you to remember that no matter where you begin, it is a journey to doing what you love that is important. Doing good for people and the world is also critical. While a cliche, I think it is important to remember that when you separate the prefix and the root word impossible, you end up with I'm possible. Look at my brother in the book. You should never let anyone tell you that your dreams and goals are impossible. And remember the importance of flexibility and tenacity. There will be moments when you stumble, but as Malcolm X said, stumbling is not falling. A true champion gets back up. So always get up! Get up! Woo! I'm proud of you all. Remember to work hard and have fun doing it. Congratulations, class of 2022!
time. We're going to appreciate him every moment we have left. And not such a man if he is. Jaden Quayam, a member of Cohort 2023, passed away last December, but he's very much in our hearts and minds today at this graduation ceremony. I'd like to ask his family to come up and join me here on stage as we take some time to include Jaden in our ceremony. From the family to just remind everybody how special Jaden was to us and to them. Jaden's mom, Samantha Quayam, who's with us today with other family members, wanted to share thoughts and memories as well as her gratitude and wishes for you, the class of 2023. They share that they struggle every day with the loss of Jaden. Too deep to put into words. The pain is crippling and hard to deal with, but there is a tremendous need to be here today to see you all transition to the next phase in your life. Additionally, she is here to represent Jaden on this very special day and to tell us how proud she and Jaden's dad are of him. She wants us all to know that Fort Hamilton High School and his friends were a very important part of Jaden's life, and that he never took his friendships for granted. She remembers how highly Jaden spoke of all his friends every day. Jaden was excited about going to college and starting the next chapter in his life to study psychology. He attended a medical school program last summer and graduated modeling school. He worked at the Heart Share program at PS 102 and used his time during the COVID lockdown to write and publish a book. He loved being part of the school newspaper and learned how to invest in stocks. He continuously challenged himself to broaden his mind. His proudest moment was when he received merit scholarship to his top two universities. The word, yeah. The words, "I can't," never entered Jaden's vocabulary. He had a great laugh, a beautiful smile, and a great sense of humor. She shares that he used to tease his dad about being shorter than him and about his lack of clothing style. She remembers him following her around the house to share her funny TikToks. Every time she would turn around, he was right there. She would tease him and say, "I'm not running away, you don't have to follow me." She misses those moments and expresses he was an amazing big brother and role model to Naim. She shares that it was truly a gift to raise such a great human being. The family is grateful to all who reached out as they were comforted by the tremendous outpouring of love for Jaden. She expresses her gratitude to his friends, parents, and the Fort Hamilton staff. A special thank you to Mr. Alvear, his favorite teacher, for the amazing article he wrote about Jaden for the pilot. Jaden had wondered what Mr. Avell wrote in his letter of recommendation, and she teased Jaden by saying, "There's nothing bad to say, you're perfect." Jaden just laughed. She also expresses gratitude to Ms. Jowie for everything she did for Jaden over these last 4 years and for responding to every phone call she made regarding Jaden. And finally, a very special thank you to his friends, classmates, for being so respectful, for loving him, and helping make him the happy kid he was. Finally, Mrs. Quam reminds the graduates of the class of 2023 that today should be looked upon as a fresh start. You have a tremendous opportunity to become anything you put your mind to. Please use Jaden's memory, his spirit, his motivation, and his passion as a blueprint for your future success. And now to give a memorial scholarship in Jaden's name is Mr. Al Veer.
Fortunate to work with Jaden on the pilot, and I feel his spirit here today. So, Jaden, I love you and I miss you. In honor of his passing, the Jaden Quayu Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Abdelmuneem Jawad for your friendship, support, and love for Jaden, as well as your dedication and understanding, the connection between health and physical well-being. Abdelmuneem, congratulations. Thank you very much.
For their courage, their strength, and their grace. And now we move forward to salute our salutatorian, Kimberly Quash.
Represent a class of over 800 graduates. How could I do it all? As a runner, I sought my answers by going on a long run. And mile by mile, my speech fell into place. As I ran, I realized the past 4 years that seemed endless, and this speech that felt impossible to complete, signified a valuable life lesson. Life is a marathon, not a sprint. We can choose the easy, fast route and speed to the finish line, like using ChatGPT to do all our work. But why do that when there is so much more to learn, cherish, and accomplish as we steadily reach the finish line? As we entered high school, we had one main target, to get to where we are now. Now we get to say, high school can kick my... Oh wait, that wasn't supposed to be. What I meant to say was, we entered this 4-year long marathon that came with many internal and external challenges. Some of us cruised through these years effortlessly, starting and finishing without breaking a sweat. But some of us came into the race much slower and had to fall to the finish line. Although we had different starts and are still chasing our own ends, we made it to this one milestone, graduation. Throughout my 4 years running track, I ran into remarkable students and even witnessed the talents of those whom I didn't know. As a proud Fort Tiger, I could already imagine future doctors, artists, performers, engineers, Army and Navy officers, and so much more. Looking at you all today, I cannot fathom how much we all persevered and beat everything that tried to stop the class of 2023 from living our high school years. Yes, the pandemic slowed us down and made us forget our paths for a moment, but we never stopped the race to hear our names being recognized today. We didn't falter to fall out of the race that easy. We saved our energy to get back into the classroom, reconnect with our loved ones, and prepare for our next steps after high school. We came out even stronger. We need to continue to hold our heads high and chase one mile after the other, milestone after milestone. The other side of the finish line tastes so much sweeter when we put in the effort and are able to reflect on all the accomplishments we have achieved on this long journey. During our struggling times, we've had the helping hands of our families, teachers, mentors, and friends who gave us the fuel and motivation to keep going. Thank you for keeping us on track, supporting us when we doubted ourselves, and now cheering us on to our new beginning. Though this moment is bittersweet, I have enjoyed the wonderful memories and friends I have made these last 4 years. I would like to personally thank my teachers, coaches, family, and friends for shaping and nurturing me into the person I am today. I encourage you all to constantly move those brilliant minds of yours and set your own finish line. I know all adults tell us this, but put in the hard work and dedication, and in no time, you will succeed in your own race. We overcame a 4-year-long obstacle and are more than ready to run even bigger races. Congratulations, class of 2023!
Good job, Community League. We now will be addressed by the Student Organization President, Yezin Brake.
Everyone, the time has come. This is amazing right now. Thank you, Ms. Mancini, Ms. Houlihan, faculty, families, and friends. I am honored to be up here today and grateful for the opportunity to address you all. You know, they told me I only had 3 minutes up here and I was disappointed. And then I remembered how much speaking goes on at graduation, and I realized, well, the shorter my speech, the quicker we get to the tossing of our caps. So let's get to it. Class of 2023, we made it. 4 years of high school, gone, done, just like that. We've learned so much. We now know how to solve the quadratic equation, identify 3 types of rocks, use a comma, and that Columbus wasn't the first to discover America. What else is there in life to learn? A lot. My fellow graduates, the first thing I want you all to remember is that after today, life will provide us with a new teacher. Since we were little, school and teachers have been filling our minds with information. to help us better understand the world we live in. They've taught us the importance of following rules and establishing a moral compass to guide our decision making. They modeled good behavior and warned us of the consequences that come with poor decisions. And it's clear that every single one of our teachers has contributed to bringing us to where we are today, right here, right now. But after today, a new kind of teacher will enter our lives. This teacher will provide a different array of challenges and introduce a different kind of catalyst for our growth, our learning, and our strides towards success. Now that teacher is experience, the raw, uncut, unpredictable, pure, saturated experiences of life, which unlike our high school years, will provide the test first and the lesson afterwards. So the more you experience, the more you will learn. Now let me tell y'all a quick story. Since about the fifth grade, I was a studious, classically trained classical pianist, taking lessons in Bay Ridge. Once I got to high school, however, I stopped taking lessons, and I stopped playing piano, and instead joined a rock band with my friends. Shout out to TUU! At that moment, I made the decision to learn the drums. I basically went from playing relaxing music written by long since dead composers to blowing people's eardrums out, mainly my parents and the poor neighbors. Since then, we performed a bunch of gigs as a band. We played right here on the Coney Island Boardwalk. We played at the Central Park Band Show, local street festivals, and we even released two original songs, Surfing in Syria and At a Glance. Feel free to give them a listen on Apple, Spotify, Music, or YouTube. I get 16 cents every time you do. Point is, had I not moved away from something that I was accustomed to and put myself in a new environment, I would not have built half the connections that I have today or acquired half the skills that I have today. Nor would I have discovered a passion that was lying dormant within me. And that brings me to my second point. Learning is a lifelong journey. It begins when you're a baby and it never ends. It's a part of us that we all can harness. Now, sometimes people like to say that they haven't discovered their passion yet, that they're waiting, they're unsure. But every single one of us should always have a passion for learning. Anthony D'Angelo said it best, you have a passion for learning, you will never cease to grow. No matter who you are, no matter what you want to do, a passion for learning will unlock your potential, guide you to where you're destined to be, and make you a lifelong learner. So graduates, as you venture into the world that awaits you after high school, I hope you'll be courageous and be willing to explore, to make mistakes, to fail, to go on a strange adventure, to disagree with those around you, talk to someone you never would talk to take risks, to put yourself in an uncomfortable situation. Seek out a new experience every day of your life. Never believe that you're too smart to learn, because knowledge is infinite in the world, and knowledge is the key to success. Now my 3 minutes are about up and I'm getting scared someone might pick me off, so I'll wrap up. But listen, because this last thing is also important. Don't ever be afraid to learn or think that learning isn't for you or learning isn't necessary. And no matter how much you know, don't ever be satisfied. So graduates, stay hungry because we have a lot of learning to do. Happy learning and congratulations.
And now our senior council president, Sarah Afiuntukwu.
Good morning, family, friends, faculty, and of course, my fellow graduates. I cannot thank you all enough for joining us here to commemorate such a special occasion. I would especially like to thank Ms. Houlihan, Ms. Mancini, and our entire staff. All of you made this possible. Thank you for all that you do. I would also like to thank my family for unconditionally having my back. The support you guys give me is unmatched, and it would take an eternity to repay you for it. So, I guess I'll start by surprising you with this speech you didn't know I was giving. I know you'll laugh at how cheesy this sounds, but Mama, Baba, Leanna, and Tarek, all I've ever wanted to do was make you proud. Looking around, I see about 1,000 graduates, each with their own beautiful story. Today, I am lucky enough to stand here hoping mine will somehow impact yours. If you know me, then you know my tendency to fixate on the tiniest details, so much so that I'll lose sight of the bigger picture. I'll grammar police the life out of my essays, but I'll lose track of my main focus. Then comes the inevitable question most of us have asked at one point. Where was I going with that again? This is what happened while writing the many, many drafts of this speech. I got lost trying to fit 4 years into 4 minutes. Thus, seeking inspiration from somewhere other than my mind and its complexities, I went back to basics by doing the first thing I ever learned how to do. I took a walk. I walked around the halls of Fort Hamilton High School, the place where I once overanalyzed my every action, whether it was the way I hung up a poster or the blueprint plans of an event. But that day, I did something different. I slowed down and I took a step back. I looked around my vast surroundings, beyond just the smallest of details. For the first time, I noticed the massive murals on the third floor. Instantly, I was hit with a childlike wonderment. They were brightly painted, extending to the ceilings. Some were even dated back to 09. They took up so much space. How did I never notice them? One in particular stood out though, naming the greats in history from Shakespeare to Einstein. The mural read, "You can quote them, disagree with them, or glorify them. About the only thing you can't do is ignore them. Because the only people who think they are crazy enough to change the world are the ones that do." I read it once, then over and over again, until the royal reds and blues of the mural were striking enough to open my eyes to the bigger picture, the one that I had lost sight of for so long. The question of where was I going with that again had been answered just by taking a step back. The reason I worked so hard and gave it my all, it wasn't just to say that I could or to create a perfectionist mindset. It was to embark on a journey to live out my wildest dreams of becoming a lawyer that changes lives. That is why I push. And if you're here today, you know why you've been pushing for the past 4 years as well. Because deep down, every single one of us today has a reason that we're here. We didn't make it this far for nothing. So don't you ever forget why you started. And if you need a reminder, just look around now. Each graduation cap we see represents just how powerfully capable our class is of accomplishing our goals. Maybe the sky didn't shine today, but we certainly will. So today, I urge you all to never lose sight of your own bigger picture and to push for your craziest dreams during the next phase of your life. And if you ever find yourself lost, slow down, take a step back, and open your eyes. Everything will be right there. you will see the true boundless beauty that's been in front of you the entire time. And when you do regain sight of your ultimate bigger picture, you will be one of those people that thinks they are crazy enough to change the entire world. And so you will. Thank you for your time, everyone. And let's hear it for the class of 2023.
Good job, Sarah. It is with pride that I introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2023, Ion Burke.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for the introduction, Ms. Mancini. And thank you, Ms. Houlihan, faculty, and parents for being with us today. And of course, congratulations to the class of 2023. Today, we're graduates. I know what you're thinking. It's not even noon yet. It's too early for this. The exact same words I said to my father as he dragged me out of bed for my first day of high school almost 4 years ago. My parents left me with a few words of encouragement as they dropped me off on that first day. We'll always be here for you. It didn't matter if it was a ride, a vote of confidence, or a $20 loan, I knew they would catch me anytime I fell. So before I really begin, I want to take a moment to thank my parents, brother, and uncle. I could not ask for a more loving and supportive family. I had actually planned on transferring out of Fort Hamilton by the end of my first week. Its size, my 3-10 schedule, and the rigor of its classes overwhelmed me. But as the deadline to transfer schools arrived, I continued extending it. I decided to give it another week before I made the move to transfer. Then another month, then another year. It wasn't until my junior year that my feelings toward Fort completely transformed from discomfort to love, gratitude, and deep admiration. Fort had finally felt like a home. I've noticed a common theme across my 4 years at Fort that made me realize why it's my home away from home. Two, actually. One is that we're always reminded to have a positive and productive day. Thank you, Ms. Houlihan. The second is that our cohort supported each other through unprecedented adversity. We will enter the history books for all we have overcome. We battled a pandemic, we dealt with the loss of loved ones, and we face an extremely competitive year of college admission. Yet through these adversities, we never faltered. And in a sense, we were the lucky class for having had a normal high school experience despite COVID, remote learning, and ingenuity. Like the students who came before us, we knew which way to run when we saw Mr. Kozlowski in the hallways in freshman year. When it came to finding Mr. Good, actually, that's still impossible. And even when the deadly disease of senioritis attacked us all, we mustered the willpower to pass our classes and walk the stage today. I bring up all these experiences to remind you of the great power we have. Anyone who has spoken with me for longer than 7 seconds knows my great fondness for Spider-Man. As the great hero once said, with great power comes great responsibility. Whatever our talent is, whether in athletics, academics, or the arts, we all have great power. And with that power, with that talent, comes a great potential and that we have to use for others and for ourselves. We have a responsibility to aid our community, ourselves, and especially each other. What makes our cohort the greatest to ever grace sports halls, factually, is our commitment to the school community, our commitment to one another. The friends I've made at Fort have cheered me on in times of happiness, lifted me up in times of sadness, and pushed me to strive for greatness. I would not be the person I am today without those of you who stayed on the phone with me until 4 a.m, helping me with studying, the teachers who reminded me of my value when I was insecure, and the counselors who lent a shoulder to cry on. And specifically, I want to mention Mr. Brown, whose jokes always made me laugh, Mr. Hajar, who showed an interest in not just my writing, but me as a person, and Mr. Sosa, who helped me grow from a timid freshman to the confident president of the National Honor Society. As you leave Fort and throw your graduation caps in the air, no matter where you go, don't forget your great responsibility. We survived one of the most challenging periods of our lives because of our willingness to uplift one another and the responsibility we assumed for each other. When you look back on your memories of Fort, you might not remember your grades or your popularity, but rather the times your friends supported you, the jokes that kept you awake during class, and the after-school hangouts on half days. Make more memories like these. Volunteer at your local soup kitchen. Make holiday cards for senior centers. And keep in contact with those long-distance friends. If you'll forgive me, one more cliche, be the heroes of your own stories. To Fort Hamilton and my fellow alumni, you all mean more to me than you could ever know. Thank you for making these the greatest 4 years of my life. I wish you all the best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you, Nina. And now Mr. Abrio will lead us in our senior stroll.
All right, Fort Hamilton High School senior class of 2023, let's go! The moment you've been waiting for has arrived. 4 years of hard work, dedication, and hopefully endless memories culminate in this moment right here before us. Yet we didn't get to this point on our own. So, since our loved ones can't come to us, I think we should come to them. With that in mind, please join me in a senior stroll to thank our family, friends, and loved ones, and then walk across that stage to commemorate your crossing home plate and officially graduating from Fort Hamilton High School. So I ask, Tigers, are you ready? If you're ready, I'm ready. Let's roll.
Thank you. important. We're trying to get all students on the field at once. All students will walk as far as you can. To the person in front of you and move up immediately.
Mohammed Abadirazak. Yusuf Amatiam. Ilaz Amatiam. Nadine Abu Hamda. Abdel Kharif. Alexis Allen Aldamora. Eftia Athanasakis. Kathy Avila. David Askizu Dio. Amin Mohammed. Bora Alba. Ruben Almesh. Asara Greenwood. Rodena Abu Bas. Julia Aksu Manitou Bas. Omar Abdeza. Omar Abdullah. Adam Ahmed. Amir Olavahi. Zeeb Abdullah. Richard Al. Zaydan Al-Naidar. Mahim Ahmed. Sheikh Abuza Haidia. Sabrine Abuze Kureya. Janet Amandama. Hani Abdel Fattah. Jasmine Alaka. Brianna Anastasi. Olympia Asher. Marina Anastasi. Andrew Aptikar. Vincenti Alessandri. Haysoon J. Brown. Antonio Aluso. Casper Pig. Lara Aljami. Ijean Alvarita. Brenda Apipan Alavara. Vanessa Avila Fernandez. Eva Ajaba. Gustavo Barria. Jackie Chen. Jason Chen. Jinghao Chen. Bulun Chen. Emily Barrera Gonzalez. Kevin Chen. Wendy Chen. Jovi Bromberg. Iman Boji Bach. Aida Basif. Emma Fadzin. Omar Boulay. Samuel Barber. Dominic Budney. Yasin Benhaljwa Hassan. Anastasia Boskova. Brian Barbosa. Giovan Abdel Satir. Nicholas Benet. Amna Bader. Dilkis Bright. Gatsumito Bright. Amjad Gumala. Adam Badawi. Antonia Baya. Sean Chapan. Myra Vermeo, Orakidia Batista, Ana Luisa Castro Rivera, Mohamed Bukar, Ivan Aldumar Rani, Mateo Brizino, Orkida Brisano, Myrna Algamu, Damaris Campos Castillo. Julia Carlson. Jasmine Arias. Ariana Dominguez. Carly Lampio. Aria Pupi Kuchani. Joseph Kande Nico. Ryan Chen. Joseph Kama. Eileen Chen. Tina Chen. Jackson Chen. Daniel Diaz. Chen. Ivan Chen. Dingwan Chen. Becky Chen. Han Chen. Aria Carrington. Adrian Cardosa. Sergio Carcimed. Yadira Cordia. Caitlin Chen. Chalin Chen. Wei Chen. Andrew Chen. Han Xuan Chen. Charles Kisako. Julian Lopez. Amir Abadullah. Olivia Coloma.
Gianna Crocco. Kaylin Cardenas. Ruby DeMarco. Angelo Amadeo. Bader Shikari. Mohamed Dahin. Michael Delatian. Joseph Cintrone, Kareem Dari, Brian Castro, Christopher Gomer, Jason Chuck, Powell Cheslak, Matthew Crane, Dimitri Trompatis, Daniel Contreras, Fiona Chow, Crystal Chen, Nicholas Cafadio, Eric Cintrone, Jimmy Chen, Hillary Casquette, Ashley Chicotero, Trevor Chu, Ryan Chen, Gabriel Chen, Adrian Chung, Aubrey Chen, Lee Wen Chen, Mark Chen, Ethan Diaz, Tijia Chen, Quina Chen, Ying Chen, Elena Chen, Gihan Alcabel, Michelle Chen, Yi-Ha Chen, Xuan-Hong Chen, Xuan-Miao Chen, Nicholas Das, Andrew Carranza, Paige Douglas, Justin Duranzo, Claudia Debkowski, Patrick Drogon, Jihad Haymore, Amin Jalil, Khalid Daoud, Rayanne Assad, Anthony DeAngelis, Sophia Dom, Sean Delatorre, Victoria DeLuca, Gabriel Hernandez, Anahi Dominguez, Grace Freeland, Isaac Diarza Reyes, Yusuf El Zayat, Darielli Espinal, Yasmin Yao, Shunhao Dong, Kevin Dong, Andreas Ernest, Nancy Ellery Shuni, Muhan Atme, Epiphany Gamagon, Hainer El Sayad, Noor El Wawa, Mehi Ebrahim, Jasmine Elvin Shawi, Sienna Flores, Joseph Cancel, Chris Freeman, CJ Fang, Sanji Martinez, Anthony Garcia, Carlos Garcia, Ozzy Flores Sanchez, Kevin Flores, Jocelyn Romero Flores, Hana Garama, Sana Fatima, Alexander Flores, Amir Faraj, Jesse Goyes, Daniel Chitarero, Alexis Guerrero, Alexis Gutierrez Cortez, Catherine Guevara Velasquez, Jonathan Estrada, Rocio Fimbo Javier, Victor Gregorio, Junior Henes Teles, Michelle Guan, Rita Gao, Peter Goudere, Vanessa Guzman, Wendy Gao, Vanna Feng, Fuad Baden, Cameron Farrell, Amanda Federico, Destiny Garcia, Anthony Garcia, Salcinio Mesu, Jada Marie Griffiths, Anthony Mike Ferrero, Richard Gear, Antonio Antonio, Jaron Gonzalez, Jason Gonzalez, Rachel Garreau, Jonathan Ramsey, Rachel Chenier, Elizabeth Mazzo, Diana Gonzalez, Kiara Demetrio Spornellos, Constantine Flores, Giovanni Guerrero, Daniel Ferris, Tyler Gibson, Nancy Hernandez, Ying Ying Hu, Leonie Holma, Alyssa Hernandez, Zoe Hong, Salma Halal, David Hirmack, Jonathan Garcia, Francisco Galindo, Emma Hee, Reina Reb, Blanca Enriquez, Ahmed Abu, Abdelrahman Gahir Rasul, Mona Staback, Aya Gumrasi, Ranad Hanafi, Noran Hamed, Hassem Hussein, Yi Huang, Yuning He, Saif Hassan, Armin Hussein, Elena Hee, Elizabeth Hari, Mohammed Harb, Yusuf Hassan, Yusuf Hamed, Ali Issa, Who Eva Huang, Joyce Hu, Jala Hassani, Balmir Hassani, Mohammed Jawad, Abdel Munim Jawad, Tammy Johnson, Stephanie Kabab, Jose Jimenez,
Sahiba Jamshad, Hashmina Jamshay, Timothy Tredrasen, Zeng Li Chen, Adrian James, Catherine Jen, Kostas Kapsala, Paula Pandy-Hewitt, Victoria Pollock, Delilah Kitsakos, Crystal Kwan, Peter Kushnerov, Sam Kochlari, Alina Kylie, Mia Kalia, Elizabeth Kessler, Dia Kutsavetis, Dihan Key, Samira Kolasinac, Eric Cooperman, Stefania Carajario, Alexandra Calderon, Georgios Kupos, Delrali Pataya, Olivia Piao, Alpita Kukai, Malak Pesh, Wen Yang Zheng, Nayeli Lagares, Christopher Lopez, Antonio Laguzzi, Tiffany Liu, Alaini Lunas, Jing Li, Huan Li, Amy Liu, Jiting Young, Helen Li, Yan Lin, Lin Lin Li, Carmen Li, Nancy Lin, Karen Shuki Li, Allison Lamb, Angelina Lee, Stephanie Lane, Ashley Lau, Dion Lu, Kin Fai Lu, Javin Lu, Alexandra LeBron, Charlize Lambert, Yachi Lin, Feiya Lin, Xi Liang, Suya Li, Chi Ting Li, Erica Lin, Jonathan Lin, Kevin Lin, Yipo Li, Ivan Lee, Wing Terry Liang, Jonathan Lopez, Andrew Lambert, Matthew Lambert, Julia Lapie, Yin Yan Liu, Ethan Liu, Becky Lee, Ada Lin, Pat Caitlin Lin, Chloe Liang, Angelina Lagana, Rick Lozano, Jacqueline Liang, Shirley Liu, Deanne Lopez, Tian Lang Lau, Alvin Lee, Isaac Locke, Cedric Liu, Yang, Zanaya Lewis, Claudia Louie, Joshua Lynch, Omar Makawi, Jasmiel Jessica Lopez, Demon Lopez, Arturo Galiz Jerez, Alisa Mascuni, Rachel Bethan, Mariana Eladek, Joanna Meza Cortez, Alicia Molina, Angelique Pugliano, Jackie Martinez, Mia Lynn Ford, Michael Malou, Adele Mosef, Brian Mayba, Matthew Martinez, George Marte, Omar Mosen, Ahmad Hamad, Ali Hamed, Hamza Mugrabi, Gabriela Mazzaferro, Tofik Mahir, Margarita Meza, Amia Mercadotova, Bennett Pizzada, Martin Salal Mohammed, Jeremy Matias, Alexander Mendes, Axel Martina, Dante Melo-Garla, Nina Orozco, Kareem Mustafa, Miriam Mustafa, Sophia Maldonado, Madeline Mays, Julia Miranda, Angelina Mora, Laura Mendieta, Karen Mendez, Dulce Martinez, Jarrett Marquez, Steven Marquez, Luna Mencia, Adam Mahara, Maxine Nicolas, Daniel Morales, Megan Moe, Fisher Martinez, Maria Martinez, Ali Mokala, Martinez Portillo, Christopher Meza, Mohamed Mostafa, Jordan Delacosta, Derek Miranda, Michael Magala, Nathan Nawaz, Shana Magori, Maisie Mullen, Michelle Martinez, Janelle Mendez, Edward Medina, Enzo Mendez, Andrika Minessa, Young Chao Mai, Yair Martinez, Valentin Morales, Alan Martinez Flores, Iris Mesa, Jose Menhara, Dennis Madasovic, Tarkan Minadasovic, Gabriel Amar, Joseph Mutasa, Jackie Lynn, Ryan Lamini, Drillin Kakajaka, Ali Osman,
Janae Lee's Myra Morgan. Ksenia Safin. Christina Noma. Jiad Kushi. Siani Roro. Jamin Yevin. Ahmed Nafi. Alexa Nelson. Daria Nazarenko. Eric Mee. Frankie Oviedo Scola. Osvaldo Perez. Angel Koku. Melissa Koku. Freddie Ortega. Christian Ortiz. Faris O'Mara. Rita Ovcharenko. Sophia Orlando. Hazel Melendez. Paula Esteprona Bauer. Noman Muted. Mohamed Hassan. Omar Osman. Roxanne Curry. Kayleen Sanchez. Samantha Mosquera. Jeremy Pasantes. Danielle Malik. Nicole Milkis. Grace Orman. Anna Petito. Natalie Torres. Janelle Celine Quiles. Ariana Padilla. Lizzie Quito Ortiz. Carmen Ong. Rachel Cho. Joseph Phillips. Isaac Pesela. John Papamitsakis. Denise Pajanto Saenz. Adriana Pepa. Sal Odigala. Brian Perez. Derek Rodriguez. Lauren O'Brien. Alicia Pena, Lisa Papadze, Natalie Shanice, Lucas Ortiz Martinez, Christopher Portolini, Shannon Pasha, Leslie Pena, Kevin Romero, Danielise Marie Perez. Sierra Pina, Joseph Reyes Gonzalez, Jenna Lee Simonez, Michael Rivera, Fatima Rahman, Randy Reyes, Lillian Racinos, Felicity Robles, Ty Ramirez, Brandon Romola, Kevin Ramirez, Hannah Soriel Pichardo, Arath Rodriguez, Juan Safi, Delilah Rivera, Dylan Raymond, Sally Palacio, Isabel Pellegrina, Carla Maria Tejada. Efimio Thrapti. Alessandra Lemayor. Johnny Rodriguez. Janelle Ramos. Trinity Ryan. Murad Radomson. Carmen Radomson. Isa Radomson. Carol Romero, Michael Russo, Hassan Amar Mahmoud Saleh, Hassan Amar Ahmad Mahmoud Saleh, Eric Sukudani, Gabrielle Zajari, Gabriel Tindani, Alvin Shakiri, Marcella Pira, UC Megaburn, Samuel Schell, Emma Nestoro, Lauren Vega, Mia Espinosa, Lily Gallo, Shanai Port, Abdallah Sakari, Justin Scott, Yael Mendez Samedra, Mohammed Shabin, Louis Altatriste, Aya Mohammed, Diana Placentia, Alyssa Leon, Ida Flores, Cassandra Gonzalez, Haley Sacco, Violet McKee, Jenna Farage, Sienna Palacio, Allison Cruz, Francesca Tavano, Jenna Mazla, Andra Shiova, Nicholas Scheffler, Taisha Zelinski, Aiden Hazel, Ariana Lucas, Anana Shahada, Kelly Chin, Jay Shu, and Doni Soto, Anthony Ritz, Sebastian Brubel, Rayon Imran, Malak Tayu, Jennifer Cortez Metzler, Elijah Martinez, Francesco Pizzula, Daniel Araco Khan, Sophia Chalet, Ashley Torres Perez, Melanie Torres, Grace Sawa, Annalise Santiago, Jody Yu, Kate Long, Kala Hamush, Trisha Stroman, Aaliyah Solomon, Hannah Tom, Emmalyn Tavares, Sophia Jung, Weiya Dong Wu, Brenda Yar, Emma Schneiderman, Elias Skulko, Daniel Spierka, Joshua Staroleski, Tyler Young, Jack John, Mohammed Sheikh, Jake Steele, Wilson Simbana, Kevin T. Lapango Sarone, Brandon Vasquez, Gloria Sanchez, Amaya Defia Ponky, Honghui Shao, Anas Steli, Noah Stern, Mahib Odin, Gabriella Stoppler, Lizzie Spaghetti, Selma Chabon, Gila Fari Sultan Tatum, Katarina Udo, Jenna Sevilla, Kimberly Salamanca, Jacqueline Sandoval Medina, Samantha Salgado, Sebastian Serrano, Angelo Santucci, Sean Sosa, Amar Salman, Abdullah Sandifa, Ahmed Salim,
Rivers. Ulysses Sanchez. Milan Soleil. Olivia Santiago. Kevin Sanchez. Carlos Saavedra. Jadi Sun. Kai Shang Sun. Mariana Sonitas. Kyle Taylor. Anne-Marie Vasquez. Adriana Vasquez. Samuel Falco. Luke Torres. Gabriel Kettler. Dee Hao Tan. Sarah Sarno. Paris Syed. Juliana Brevi. Jasmine Sotolongo. Jocelyn Tapia. Nicole Vega Varela. Jennifer Teapox. Doris Tenelamea Nea. Louis Sabasili. Gregorio Tapia. Guadalupe Vargas. Jeffrey Tang. Brandon Vasquez. Kiana Martin. Jesus Feliz. Noemi Vasquez. Brittany Toe. Axel Vasquez. Nicholas Ting. Kayla Velez. Sita Benin. Tao Chun Wang. Yu Yi Zhang. Wen Fan Tang. Zhang Zai Tang. Darren Wang. Jenny Wang. Sonia Wu. Justin Wong. Jack Wang. Peter Wang. Linda Wu. Damarian Washington. Giovanni Vasquez. Evangeline Wang. Sarah Vranici. Ariel Urban. Ryan Wout. Hover Wu. Scarlett Wong. Abdelrahman Zaman. Nicole Yan. Joanna Zhang. Jing Zhu. Nicole Zhang. Brian Zhang. Derek Zhang. Jason Zhang, Conway Zhu, Aiden Zhang, George Zhang, Eric Zhang Wu, Jamie Zhang, Sebastian Zhang, Denha Zhang, Alan Zhang, Yupei Yu, Jiang Zhu Wang, Jason Zhang, David Zhang, Yuxin Wu, Wei Yi Yan, Jesse Wang, Joey Wu, Jarina Wang, John Cero Amigo, Wei Ji Wang, Hong Wei Wang, Qi Han Wang,
Wang, Oscar Zhang, Liliana Zhang Zhang, Christine Gan, Selena Zhu, Jessica Zambrano, Valentina Zhang Yi, Robert Zhang, Novia Zhang, Steven Zhang, Kevin Zhang, David Zhou, and Zhang Zhu. Congratulations to the class of 2023. Ms. Houlihan, I certify that the students that appear before us are graduates of the class of 2023. Please come up and make your assistance for the declaration.
All right, 2023, we have two more tasks. One, the commencement declaration, and you're going to repeat after me. Stand. Thank you. With gratitude to my school. With pride in my city. And with devotion to my country. I pledge as a graduate to cherish the traditions of Fort Hamilton High School. And as a citizen, to work both alone and with many to improve my city. And as an American, to obey my country's laws and support and defend its constitution. Now the best part before the thunder continues. By the power invested in me by the New York City Department of Education, I pronounce you high school graduates.